Some families were petting animals one minute and running from one the next. WYFF News 4's Mike McCormick tonight with what happened when a bull got loose at the Hollywild Animal Park.
I'm a good boy.
This is Ego, and as calm as he looks now, people are saying he put the wild in Hollywild Wednesday night.
He was scared. It wasn't the bull's fault.
After feeling threatened by the bison in his pen, Ego jumped the fence and ended up in the middle of Santa's Village at the nonprofit's nightly Holiday Light Safari.
He would lower his head and start stomping his foot, and he was ready to charge.
Ethan Boulding was there with his family.
The bull charged the fence. People were jumping over the fence.
And Jessica Martin was there with hers.
Hauled it to the car as fast as I could, put my daughter up on my friend's roof rack of her vehicle. I didn't have keys.
Boulding used his body to protect his wife, kids, and mom.
I thought he was going to smell it. No, he didn't want to do that. He just whooped his head real quick, and that's when he ripped my jacket. I didn't have time to be scared. All I was thinking, I was in survival mode.
The park's executive director, David Meeks, ultimately got hold of Ego by this tree and took him back to his pen.
Not in 22 years we've done this. We never had one come out like that, no.
They didn't seem prepared. I was waiting on a tranquilizer.
Because if you tranquilize one, it takes 15 to 20 minutes for it to even take effect. We don't want to wait 15 to 20 minutes.
I don't want it to be, you know, damaged, the reputation damaged. What I want to see is some safety issues laid down.
Meeks says Ego will now be in his own stall during the nightly event.
It's absolutely safe.
It really scared us. This really could have turned out a lot worse.
The Holiday Light Safari here at Hollywild will remain open through January 4th. Mike McCormick, WYFF News 4 in Spartanburg County.
I just want to say